Hi guy, in today's video, I will show you how to create a virtual machine on a VMware ESXi 7.0. It's a pretty simple process, and in this video, I will show you how to create and install a TrueNAS Core at the virtual machine. As you know, the FreeNAS 11.43 soon gonna be TrueNAS Core. It's still running on free PSD, so I would advise you to hold back and using the FreeNAS 11.43. You can try it out, TrueNAS Core, just to see what the difference is and the features that the TrueNAS Core offer. It is still free, even though they changed the name to TrueNAS Core. It's still running on free BSD, so pretty much the same like FreeNAS 11.43. And with that, let's get started. So first, before you start creating the virtual machine, we have to make sure that we enable the pass-through mode for the HBA. So we're gonna go to manage, and right here you see I have one HBA in the IT mode, Avago. LSI firmware currently installed on the Dell R620, and the pass through mode right now is currently disabled, so we're gonna go ahead and enable it. Okay, so it failed to enable the PCI pass through. I'm not sure what's going on, but you see right here, it says configuration will be applied after reboot. So we're going to go ahead and reboot the host, and hopefully it will enable the pass through after we reboot the host. Alright, so we're going to go ahead and reboot it. Alright, so we have the VMware ESXi host rebooted. So now we're going to go check to make sure that the HBA controller is pass-through mode have been active or enabled. So we're gonna go to manage, and as you see right here, the HBA controller, the pass-through mode have been active or enabled. The next step is we're gonna go to storage, vmfs storage, and we if you haven't re-ate one, you can check out one of my last tutorial when I show you how to create a vmfs storage. Or if you do not have one, you can just go to storage and you create a new data storage. And with that, we're gonna go to a data store browsers, and I'm gonna create a new directory. I'm gonna call it ISO, and this is why I'm gonna store all the OS or operating system image or ISO file. Alright, we're gonna go ahead and upload the TrueNAS Core that I have downloaded earlier. TrueNAS Core. Alright, now that we have the TrueNAS Core 12.0 upload it into the ISO directory, the next step is to create a virtual machine. So I'm gonna go ahead and close it out and go to virtual machines, and we're gonna create a new one, create a new virtual machine, and I'm gonna name it TrueNAS Core, and OS family is gonna be other, and OS version is gonna be since it's TrueNAS 12.0, I would assume it's running on the free PSD 12, and obviously it's gonna be a 64-bit versions. And next, and I'm gonna store it on the USB data storage. Alright, CPUs. This is depend on how many your system capability. I'm gonna give it 4 CPUs for now. And the memory is it's gonna be the minimum requirement, which is a gigabyte by TrueNAS. and hard disk, I'm gonna give it 16 gigabyte. And we can mount the ISO file from data storage. We're gonna mount the TrueNAS ISO file, select that one, and we're gonna add in another other devices. It's gonna be the PCI device. And there you go, because I only passed through one PCI, so it's automatically select the HPA controllers. And next. Alright, and finish. Okay, now we have a virtual machine. We're gonna go ahead and start the virtual machine. Power it on. Oh, there's some issue with the memory reservation. So we're gonna go ahead and edit the virtual machine. Go back to the memory. So we can research all guest memory for FreeNAS. Alright, and here we go, we should be able to power it on. Okay, we're gonna hit enter, so we're gonna boot into TrueNAS. And we're gonna install and upgrade. And I'm gonna install it on the VMware virtual disk. So, okay. And yes. And then we're gonna create a password for TrueNAS. The default user is gonna be a root, and password is whatever that you put in here. And we're gonna boot via BIOS. You can still follow this tutorial if you decided to install FreeNAS 11.43, which is I highly recommend it. At the moment, TrueNAS Core is still beta. We mean that they still try to work it through and fixing all the bugs, so it's not ready for in production environment yet. You can try them out, but if you're using it on a production environment, I still strongly advise you to use the FreeNAS 11.43 until TrueNAS Core is finally officially released by IX system or TrueNAS. Okay, so the TrueNAS installation succeeded. So now we're gonna reboot. We go ahead and reboot the system. Alright, so we have the TrueNAS Core installed and successfully boot. We're gonna go ahead and access this via the web user interface. So it's gonna be 192.168.149.240. And it pretty much looked the same as FreeNAS 11.43 interface. The only thing really changed is the name TrueNAS Core. And let's log in with the root user. Alright, so here we have TrueNAS 12.2 beta installed on the VMware virtual machine on the ESXi 7.0. Let's see a few things. What's the difference between TrueNAS Core and FreeNAS 11.43? It looks pretty much the same. Yep, everything still look the same. Services. All right, in addition to TrueNAS, I think TrueNAS offered a feature that not available in FreeNAS 11.43 Open VPN client and Open VPN servers. This definitely gonna help out a lot of users. Open VPN client and Open VPN servers, to set it up, it can be a little bit complicated even for network administrators. So with the interface services, it's gonna help out with setting up the Open VPN servers, so you can access your FreeNAS remotely and securely instead of open it freely on the internet, just a lot of users currently do right now. And hopefully I can release the next tutorial on Open VPN client and Open VPN server soon on my channel. If you think the video is helpful, don't forget to subscribe and like. And like always, thank you for all the subscriber, the one that are supporting my channel. I really appreciate it, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Thank you and bye.